Hi, this is Mary Morrissey. Congratulations, you're back for video two. This is called The Power of Paradigms. And remember, in the last video, we talked about the way to discover your dream is to do some of the most difficult thinking and imagining you're going to do, and that's to stay inside the question, what would I love? Not what do I think I can do, but what would I love my life to be like? You start generating ideas. Now, I can promise you that right behind coming up with a dream you would love to live is going to be some stuff. Because your life as it is right now is going to start screaming at you. And it's going to say, well, you don't have the money, and you don't have the time, or you don't have the contacts, or you don't have what this dream is. You don't have it. Of course you don't. And this is a way in which today, as we spend this time together, we're going to look at how you don't ignore the facts of your life, but you don't let the facts control what can be. See, most of us have been trained to actually live our lives backwards. We come into this world and we get told how the world works. And we become what's called condition-based in our thinking. So we look to the conditions of our lives to give ourselves permission for what we can be, what we can do, what we can go, where we can go, what we can have, what we can dream. And it's really backwards because look around. Everything that's around you was an idea before it became a thing. The books behind me, somebody thought that book up, every one of these. Somebody thought it up, and probably the first thought they thought was, how am I going to write a book? I've never written a book before. I don't have the, and of course they didn't. But they didn't let the fact that they didn't have exactly what it was going to take to build the book, bring the book about, to stop them maybe from taking the thing they did have, which was maybe a piece of paper and a pen, and start writing. Now, in dream building, you are using inner technology that you're using all the time anyway, just like your television. If it's been, you've been tuned to CNN, there is inside that unit technology where you could tune to a different frequency and actually the picture would change and you would move from CNN and you would move to Discovery or Home and Garden or whatever else you're interested in. So now that you have built a wavelength of your interest, I'm interested in a life where I'm happy. I'm interested in a life where I can do this and I can do that and I can have this and I can give this, whatever the this is, that is unique to you. It's a discover your dream, what matters to you. Remember, all the power in your car, you sitting there with the key, will not take you anywhere unless you have an idea about where you want to end up. The ideal where you want to end up, we call a dream. Now, again, this is not necessarily a life-changing, but it can be little things that then begin to teach you about how it is that you use the same understanding and the same technologies, really, of how you think in ways that open up doors to you. And first it's a little thing, then it becomes a bigger thing, and then pretty soon you let yourself dream in ways you would have never given yourself permission to dream before. And more than that, you begin to understand how ideas that are harmonized with through the invisible laws of this universe and you actually bring them about. And just an example of that, you know, it's I start studying this in 1971. I study it for a decade before I ever teach it. And then I begin to explore different ways of trying this out. So I have a dream to build a piece of work where I will do some teaching. So I have this dream and I'm doing the work and I actually open a place. I take that dream and I begin to bring action to it. And I actually open a place where I'm teaching every single weekend. And I thought all I had to do, I'm young and I just am so turned on by this teaching and I'm seeing what it's done in my life and my friends who are interested, and not every friend was interested, but the ones who were, I saw their lives radically changing and their all sorts of things they started to allow to happen in their lives that they never allowed before. And I thought all I had to do was open the doors and whew, everything would happen. I didn't understand that there was an inner state that I had to hold in order for my reflected world to both change and then stabilize that change. The same thing's going to happen for you. I didn't understand the power of paradigms. I didn't understand that I had actually inside of me a thermostatic setting about how much good I would allow in my life. Now, the difference between a thermostat and a thermometer reads the conditions around it and tells you what they are. It's 72, it's 84. It reads the conditions and then reflects those conditions. A thermostat, on the other hand, sets the conditions. Now you have an inner thermostat. It's called your self-image. It got patterned into you, things you told yourself, things that were said to you, what the world told you, all kinds of things have built an image of who you think you are and what you think you're worth. And if you want to know what that is, you can take a look at the reflected reality of that inner image and you'll see a life you're living. And if you dream beyond the current form of your life, your dream will be bigger, more energy, more positive energy than the life you're living. And that life you're living right now is speaking to you through your five senses and saying, whoa, wait a minute, you don't have what's required. So I didn't know that I had this inner thermostat. I just have a dream and I can see it in my mind, but it's not established in the real world. And then I came upon a piece of work, a study about how it is that every single one of us has paradigms. And unconsciously, we're governing how much positive energy we'll allow in our lives, and then how to change a paradigm and open yourself to more positive energy. You're in, literally, right now, a universe of unlimited energy. It's here right now. And you and I don't have a lack of energy from which. You can think a thought as big as you want, or as little as you choose. You can think, how do I get to the end of the month and pay my bills? Or you can think, how would I go to the south of France and spend a couple of weeks and make an extra $10,000 doing it? The universe doesn't care what thought you think any more than your Google box cares what you put in the question. But know this, the moment you ask the question, or the moment you level, say your interest inside that box, here's what I'm interested in, whew, the search engines go looking for everything like what you're interested in. So right now, today, we have a dream, some idea of a life we would love living. And I would encourage you, as you're learning the dream building set, all the tools that are required to build any dream, think of it this way. If you wanted to learn how to do woodworking or build something, and eventually your big dream was perhaps to build your brand new house, but you never built anything, you would want two things. You would want to get the basic skill set, the hammer, the saws, the drill, the nails, the screwdriver, and you would want to put yourself with some kind of master craftsman, or at least somebody who knew more about building than you do. That's what I started doing. In 1971, I studied till 1981. Then as I began to teach this, I still sat at the feet of people who knew more about it than I did, so they could help me challenge my paradigms. And when I would think that it's just not going to work, they'd say, wait a minute. And they would help me think past whatever the problem was, recognizing that you cannot have a problem. Think about it this way. You cannot have a math problem for which the law of mathematics doesn't have an answer. You cannot have a dream for which the universe doesn't know how to bring it about. You may not know how, but the universe does. And when you stand in that premise, it actually helps you do some of the things we're going to be talking about in these videos. And also, I want to let you know that at the end of the third video, you're going to have a chance, you probably do on this video as well, to sign up for a live teleclass that I'll be doing, where I'll have a chance to really spend enough time with you, 75 minutes, to really move through some of the technology, some of the understanding. And you will, and I'm going to encourage you to come to that teleclass with a pad and paper, because the things that we'll be talking about, you'll get some very clear key ideas for how to apply it to your dream. Now remember, it starts with something you would love to live. So here I am, I've started the work, I'm renting a place, I'm showing up, and a handful of people are coming. You know, in the beginning, the first week, there were 22 people. It was my mother, my father, my sister, you know, some close friends, and a couple other people who probably saw the ad I put out. The next week, there were 6 people. And that's where it started from. And so after several years of this, now it's up to 50 people, but I'm struggling. And I have no idea that really what is going on is that I have a paradigm. And the truth is, if somebody said to me, Mary, what would it be like if you would speak for 300 people? Inside, I felt terror. So what I was creating in my life was a world that reflected my comfort zone. What I thought I could do, what I thought I could establish, and yet my longing was way more than what I was currently creating. And I had to learn not only that there was an inside part of me that was governing the reality I was experiencing, but I had to learn how to change that thermostat from here to here. It is no less than learning how to get off CNN and get on Discovery, to get off a frequency that keeps your life locked in some sort of struggle or difficulty, and open up to a level of freedom, opportunity, experience that the most natural thing is several times a day, what rises up inside of you is, I love my life. Now below, you're going to see a chance where you can sign up for the live teleclass. 75 minutes, where I'll have a chance to really walk you through some of the very clear, systematic ways in which you break down those paradigms and establish higher order paradigms, a higher order structure by which more positive energy moves through your life, by which you actually are able to see the very things you're dreaming about start to become the very reality of your life. And I'll be sharing with you what happened, what is the one thing I learned that changed that 50 person into 4,000 people coming. And there's a process by which that's done, and I'm going to give it to you. So sign up for the live teleclass. Have a great day.